Hey, my name is Liz and I sell on eBay, Poshmark, and Mercari, and today I have a haul for you. It is two kind of smaller hauls from two different thrift stores that I've been to in the past about a week. They're actually both local thrift stores. To me in New Jersey, they aren't like a Goodwill or anything. And I will get started. The stuff was like good. There wasn't anything amazing in one I just went today, and then I don't 100% remember what's in the other one. So it'll be a part of a surprise for me too. Some Madewell jeans. These are the Perfect Vintage jean, which is one of my favorite styles to sell. I've sold, I don't even know how many at this point, probably 10, 12, something like that. $10. It's about what I will pay for jeans, somewhere between 8 and 12 is normally the range that I am willing to pay. These are some Lululemon. They were $6. They are definitely an older style, but my stores usually mark Lulu up pretty high, and these were a size 10. So I know that they're older, A, because you can kind of just tell, but also the size dot doesn't have the numbers around it. So I grabbed them because size 10 is definitely a good size, and they do at least have pockets on the side, so that is good too. I should hopefully be able to find the style on those. And this is one of the better finds. This is S13, which sometimes you'll see this tag and sometimes it'll be S-A-M, Sam. They're both, I think, the exact same brand. I don't think there's any difference. I don't know why there's two different names, but this is a girl's, I think, size 12. Yeah, jacket. It was $10. It's probably retailed for about $250. It is July when I'm filming this, but I am starting to look at some winter stuff while no one else in the store seems to be, and I've come across a handful of decent jackets. So I'll probably list this one for close to 100 because it's in really good shape. This was actually, I don't find this too often now. I don't know if this piece is fantastic, but this is Johnny Was, and this was marked at 40. I paid 20 for this, but I grabbed it because it is quite embroidered, so it has florals down the opening of both sides of the cardigan, along the bottom and on the hood. His embroidered stuff definitely does better, as we've all seen, I'm sure. This is a size small, and there was actually a second Johnny Was piece there today. It was like a tunic that was like sheer and pretty embroidered too, but that wasn't on sale, and that was 40, and that just felt like too much to me to pay for that. These are just some shorts for my husband. I grabbed a couple kids things. So these are a set of Hannah Anderson pajamas, size 5. They're a little bit older, I figured, based on the style. They're from 2013, but they're in really good shape, and it was the full set, so I grabbed them for $3. Figured people still like owls. I figured it was a little older because I don't see this style of shirt too much anymore from their newer stuff, but probably list those for about 20. And then this is another pair of Lulu. These ones I think were also on the older side. They are size 4, but these were only $4.99, so that's why I grabbed these. They do have pockets. They are definitely a low rise, and then they kind of have like scrunching at the ankles, but for $5, I was happy to snag those. And then these are Frame, and I saw probably 4 other pairs of Frame, but for the price that they had them, I won't pick up Frame skinny jeans. These were $10, and they're actually a jogger, which I haven't had this style before. There's a little bit of a mark right here that I think I should be able to get out. Grab these for 10. I figured they were a different enough style that I'd give them a shot. Frame is an expensive brand, but the resale is not fantastic on them. And this is Mini Bowden. I found two Mini Bowden pieces today. There's actually a third, but it was pretty faded, so I left that one behind. This is like a chambray dress with unicorns, kid size 6-7, and that was $4. I'll probably list this for $25. I love their stuff, it's always so cute. And this is the other piece, and this is also unicorn, so I wonder if they were from the same little girl, because it just feels funny that it was both unicorn pieces. This one was $3 and size 7-8, and it is just a skirt, not a skort. It almost looks like it could be reversible if you wanted it to be, besides that it has the tags on it, but even the lining is so cute. Probably list this for about $25 too, since it has the applique on it. That is the first bag. And then I found two of these, and they are the brand Parachute. They're bathrobes. And this is an expensive, like bedding, linens brand, and they also, I guess, make bathrobes. Now, the downfall is that neither of them have belts, but at the bins, I picked up a couple random bathrobe belts, because you do often find them with no belts. So I'm gonna just stick, I know I have at least one gray belt that I'm gonna stick with one of these, and then at least I've had this Skims bathrobe that has no belt that I've relisted like 4 times, and each time it's gotten 50 plus likes, but it never sells because it doesn't have the belt. So I'm gonna see if sticking a random belt with these helps. One was $3.99, one was $4.99, and I think I should be able to get about 50 for them, even without the matching belts. And this, I think I'm gonna keep if it fits me. It is this like sweatshirty jacket from Gap. It has the tags on it still. It was $70. I paid $8, but hoping that I like that for myself. And then this is another jacket. This is from Abercrombie, and it is a size extra, extra small, but I don't think that will be too big of a problem in that brand, honestly. This is like a cropped puffer in a pink velvet. Now Abercrombie doesn't put dates on their stuff usually, so I don't know how old it is, but I'm willing to guess it's within the last like 3 years. I'm pretty sure it has down in it. So cute. I'm hoping to list this for like $75. And then the last piece from this day is a leather jacket. And now this store has fantastic brands always, but they are absolutely looking things up in the back or have like a huge list of brands or something, and they missed this one. So this is ATM, which it's black on black, so it's hard to see, but this is a good brand. It doesn't always resell amazing, but for $9 and it being actual leather, it was worth the grab for me. I'm hoping to list this for like $60, I think. We'll see when I like really look up comps if it might be better. So all of that was $111. So I think that was a pretty good haul for that price. The couple of jackets will more than pay for my entire haul. So then this is the other one. A few hard goods this day, which I'm not a hard goods seller by any means. This is just for my sister. I thought she would like this. This was $3. But the other ones I intend to sell, and I have them wrapped in the clothes, so I just wanna snag them out before I accidentally drop anything. Okay, so we'll start with them. So I found some Anthropologie mugs. So I've actually had this one before, so I knew right off the bat that this is Anthro. I think they still even have this one in the store. These were all 99 cents. It has by Anthro on the bottom. This is Sharpie from them that should come off with nail polish remover. I think from Anthro this sells for like $15, so probably list it for about 12. Just wanted to try something different and fun. And then there was also these two, each 99 cents. And I will probably list them for about the same. And then this one I might keep myself. This is Wedgwood, which is a decent China brand, but normally it's as a teacup, it'll have the little plate. But I love the pattern of this, so this might just go in my china cabinet for my own decor. So otherwise, it is my normal kind of stuff. So if you, the tag is missing from this one, but I want to say I paid like $8. If you are also on Instagram or TikTok, I get ads for this dress company constantly. It's Ivy City Co. And they make a lot of like really feminine, twirly, girly dresses. This one has gold stars on it. Super pretty. Their dresses are over 100. So hopefully I'll have to look up this specific one, but looking to try and get about 60 on that. It'll depend a little bit on if it's still in stock or not on their website. I feel like it is because I've seen that style before. And then a couple pairs of shoes. So these are like creepers, loafers. The brand is Tuck, T-U-K. And these are sold from Dolls Kill. So they're like a kind of metallic style. I paid 10 for these. They have that on the bottom. And hopefully try and get like 40 or so. I definitely don't have great shoes in my area. They're usually expensive and not always the best, honestly. For how good the clothes are, like you'd think I'd have really great shoes too, but I really don't. Or there's like just shoe sellers who take them all. But I also got these Ferragamos. They are like a loafer with a little heel. They are a normal width, which with Ferragamos definitely check, because sometimes you'll come across them and they'll be like triple A. Weirdly, the bottom is kind of sticky, so I have to see if I can do anything about that. But otherwise, they're in good shape. These were $10. They had them at 19, but they were half off. And then last is this pair of Kids Keens. And I have had great luck selling these, especially they're in season right now. These were $5. I'll probably list them for about 25 and hope they sell pretty quickly. And then I do enjoy to pick up some Talbots. So this is a size large and it's like a sweater blazer cardigan. I loved the style of it. The colors are really cute. This was $6 and probably list that for about 50. And I think this is Target as well. Yes, this is a size 16W. Paid $7 for this one, and it is another blazer, and it has leather pockets. Talbots blazers do really well for me, especially in bigger and plus sizes, so when I can get them for a decent price, I try to grab them. I also do really well with Talbots new with tag stuff. Now this I will be keeping for myself. I have been wanting a jacket from the brand S13 or Sam that I was showing you before. They're really known for like the super high sheen puffers for adults, but I haven't pulled the trigger on spending $500 or whatever on them. So this is kind of a dupe for it. It's actually just from Gap, but I'm gonna replace one of my other jackets with this one, and I paid $5 for it. So that is a good enough dupe for me. That might even be worth selling on its own for like 40 or so, but I'm definitely keeping that one. Then another brand that I do really enjoy to sell blazers from is J. Crew. There's a handful that are fantastic to sell. This is a little older, from 2014, but I only paid $4 for it. So I grabbed it. The Schoolboy does super well from J. Crew. Their like sweater blazer does really well. Probably list this for $40 or so. And then just a few more pieces. This is Mini Bowden as well. And this is a romper. It's a little bit of a bigger size. I think it's like a girl's 12, girl's 13, 14, which is like an iffy size for kids, in my opinion, because a lot of the time by that age, they don't want to wear the kids' stuff. So they're, you know, trying to get in like an extra small and adults or whatever. So I don't always pick up the bigger sizes, but I thought this was really cute and kind of classic. So I feel like there's still some girls that would like to wear that. I paid $4 for that one. And then this is a set of pajamas, and these are from Draper James, and they're 1X. Oh, these are obviously probably someone's Christmas pajamas, but it was the pants and the top. So great to have the full set. Let's see. I don't know where the tag went, so I'm not sure how much. Oh, okay. They were $4 for this set. So I haven't sold pajamas from them before, but looking to hopefully try for about $40 on those. And then to finish us off, we have two pairs of jeans, and these are another pair of Madewell and also the Perfect Vintage jean. These ones aren't distressed, but I've sold this jean enough times that I pretty much just look up the code and then I know that I already have a listing. So all I have to do is go and copy it, change the size, and we're good. And then last is some Girlfriend jeans, another really expensive brand. It does okay in the resale world. They have some distressed knees on them. These are the Carolina, which is probably one of the more popular styles. The colorways, I Put a Spell on You, but hopefully try and get like 60 on those. And yeah, that is everything. So thank you for watching, and if I have stuff listed before I put this video out, I will pop the pictures of stuff so you can see the actual price that I listed it for, and I will see you next time.